dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind. We can go if we want to, night is young and so am I. And we can dress real neat from our hats to our feet and surprise them with a victory cry. See, we can act if we want to, if we don't nobody will. And you can act real rude and totally removed, and I can act like an imbecile. See, we can dance, we can dance, everything's out of control. We can dance, we can dance, we're doing it from pole to pole. We can dance. We can dance, everybody look at your hands. We can dance, we can dance, everybody's taking the chance.
It's safe to dance, oh, well, it's safe to dance. Yes, it's safe to dance.
We can dance if you want to. We've got all your life in mind. As long as we abuse it, we're never gonna lose it. Everything will work out right.
Hi, I'm John.
Hi, I'm Mike.
And we're here to tell you about the importance of safety glasses and hard hats in the workplace.
Good thing I was wearing my hard hat.
You should wear hard hats whenever there's a chance of anything falling and hitting you in the head. But it should not be the only thing you wear. You should also wear any other required PPE for the activity that you are doing.
Very important.
Oh no. My bad.
Good thing I was wearing my hard hat.
There was a risk of something falling, so it's a good thing he wore his hard hat. If it were something heavier, he could suffer from a serious injury or even death. Now, let's talk about safety glasses. Hey Mike, catch.
Ah, good thing I was wearing my safety glasses.
Safety glasses are important to protect you from getting things in your eyes. If he wasn't wearing glasses, he would be at risk of being temporarily or even permanently blind.
That's right.
When wearing safety glasses, it's important to make sure that they're clean at all times. Wearing dirty glasses can lead to eye strain.
Good thing I was wearing my safety glasses.
As you can see, safety glasses and hard hats can go a long way in protecting you.
That's why it's important to wear proper safety gear.
Catch us next time.
'Cause if the power was off. Trust me, I learned the hard way.
Eric!
What?
Nothing. Gotcha.
See if the power was off first. That means there's no electricity going to it and you're safe from being electrocuted. The switch isn't everywhere, but here in HVAC, that's how we check.
So what do you do if there's no switch?
Use a meter to test for the voltage.
Oh, I know how to do that. The multimeter has multiple settings, which are voltage, resistance, continuity, capacitance, and amperage. It's important for you to put it on the right setting so you don't break the meter, since some only work when the electricity is off and others when it's on. For what we're doing, you first gotta turn the meter to voltage.
So with the black lead, you go to the white wire, and with the red lead, you go to the black wire.
And since we have a number, that means we have power.
Would that kill you?
No, it's not the voltage that kills you, it's the amperage.
Amperage?
Yeah. Amperage is the current through the system. 0.1 to 0.2 amps is enough to kill you.
Wow, that's whack! That's a really small number.
Also, the voltage we're working with is 120 volts.
It's important to know the voltage you're working with. And since when there's no power, that means there's no reading, which means it's safe to work with. Okay, all done.
Time to go get a teacher to check our work.
Very good, Eric.
Thanks, bud.
It's important to get a teacher to check your work before you turn the power on. That way you don't hurt yourself or short anything.
All right, let's go get them.
Yep, let's do it.
Yep, let's go.
All right.
Let's go.
All right.
Mr. LaJoy, can you check our work, please?
Yeah, sure. Let's go.
Single file.
So we have the power that's off. Excellent. Wiring looks good. Thanks for being so responsible and coming to get me to check your work.
Thanks, Mr. LaJoy.
We can act if we want to. If we don't, nobody will. And you can act real rude and totally removed. And I can act.
Oh, Elise, make sure you know what type of refrigerant we're working with.
We're working with refrigerant 134A. Wait! Make sure you have your gloves on!
Oh, thank you!
Make sure you have your safety glasses on. I can't believe I would do this to my eyes. Now that we know that the gauges and refrigerant tank are properly closed, we can safely disconnect it now.
If you don't check them, the refrigerant can get released into the air, depleting the ozone layer and breaking EPA regulations.
Another reason that you should make sure that the tank is properly disconnected is that refrigerant is heavier than oxygen, and that if you get refrigerant in your lungs, then you will suffocate. Now that we are finished using this, I'm going to safely store this in the refrigerant cabinet. Follow me.
Stay cool!
We can leave your friends behind, because your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine.
What's that smell?
I think the torch might be leaking.
It must be acetylene leaking out. It's important to check all the fittings and make sure that there's nothing flammable over it.
Yikes! There's a sweatshirt here. We shouldn't have this around while we're brazing. We shouldn't start the torch because we don't even have a brazing rod yet. We shouldn't start the torch before we're ready to use it.
Did I hear brazing rods? I have two, right here. One for me, one for you. Keep it sweet, Cheeks.
Thank you.
Now we're ready to braze.
Don't point the torch at the tank. We wouldn't want that small leak that we found earlier to lead to an explosion. Also, don't point the torch at me.
Oh, I won't. Now that we're done, it's important to let people know that it's hot and placed on the burner.
Well, what should you do if you happen to burn yourself?
First thing you should do is put it under cold water for 2 to 3 minutes and then put an ice pack on it and go to the nurse.
All right, let's wrap this up.
Okay, let's make sure that we bleed the hose of any excess acetylene.
Now where does this go?
This should be placed in tool crib away from flames and electrical.
Go team!